My name is Sarfraz Manzoor, and I wrote the book Greetings from Bury Park, which is the inspiration for Blinded by the Light. In the fall of 1987, I meet a guy in college, and he is listening to Bruce Springsteen.
Bruce is the direct line to all this true in this shitty world. Seriously. You can't start a fire
without a spark. What really hit me is that this was music that wasn't about escapism, it was about confrontations. It was about actually confronting questions about parenthood, about being a son, about what it's like to grow up in a fairly crap town and want to have something different, and that's what connected with me.
Jazz, I need your help. Bruce tickets come on sale today.
You should go. You might never get to see Bruce again.
I've literally lost count of how many times I've seen him, but it's in the 150 range. Basically, from 1992 to around about maybe 2005, I didn't miss a single show in Britain at all.
Bruce Springsteen, please tell me you still have tickets.
I think it was Springsteen that affected why I do what I do.
You're a Muslim, aren't you?
Yeah.
The Pakistani into Springsteen. Now that's got potential. Sharpen the opening and I'll run it.
Yeah, good, got that, very good.
Okay. I first met Sarfraz when he had written an article about Bruce Springsteen in a paper. And I was like, wow, here's another Asian person who likes Springsteen. That's really unusual.
I then got contacted by a literary agent who said, do you think there's a book in any of this? And I thought the book was going to be about the two key people in my life. So it was going to be about Springsteen and it was going to be about my dad.
Remember, stay away from the girls.
My dad died a couple of days before I turned 24. And so in the book, I wanted to try and unpack and say some of the things that I wanted to say about him and to him that I couldn't say.
I know having dreams doesn't make me a bad son. I also know that everything I am is because of the sacrifices my mum and dad made.
So the book became a kind of a love letter and a salute of thanks to my dad and to Springsteen.
He showed me a very early copy of it and I said, this is great, Sarfraz. This isn't a movie here, but I know how to turn it into a movie.
Now, I don't want to alarm anyone, but you know who'll be watching this? Bruce Springsteen.
I said, there's no way this film is gonna happen without Bruce Springsteen's blessing. As luck would have it, I was invited to the premiere of The Promise, and Bruce was coming.
Rather than inviting her husband, she said, you can be my plus one. So we were both there together.
We both stood on the red carpet. As he approached, an amazing thing happened. He saw Sarfraz, whom he recognized from having seen him about 100 times in concert. And there aren't many Pakistanis with afros in the front row of Bruce concerts.
It's been a while.
He comes up to me and then tells me that he loved the book.
The book was really beautiful.
You read it?
Yes.
Oh, my God.
It was really a lovely thing.
We both said, well, we really want to make a film. I made Bender like Beckham. Please, can you help us?
That was one of those kind of triggering moments where it sort of made us think, well, if Bruce knows the book and likes it, there is at least a chance that he might give us approval for using music.
The next thing we had to do was write a script that Bruce would like.
So it took 5 years from 2012, from Gurinder saying, we think the script's now ready enough to send to Springsteen, but we think you should write him a letter. And so I sat down and I just had to write a letter, literally, Dear Bruce.
In those weeks after the script went off to Bruce, it was very nerve-wracking because we didn't know if he'd even remember us.
And then in June of 2017, and I get a phone call, and it's Gurinder, and she said, we've just heard from Bruce.
He said, I'm good with this. Go for it. Bruce! So I couldn't really believe it at the time. It took a while for it to sink in.
It's like the most crazy, crazy thing in the world to have somebody whose music has utterly defined and shaped you and tell you that he has spent time reading your story and appreciates something that you've created. That is an absolutely insane feeling. So there have been so many peaks, from the moment of Bruce saying that he liked the book, to the moment where he says yes, to the first day of set in the same cafe that you actually go to, and there's an entire feature film crew there. It's a once-in-a-lifetime experience, you know. You can't ever imagine what it could be like to have this being done to you. It's funny, because when I look at photos of it, it almost feels like it was a dream.
So the first time I saw this film with the public was at Sundance. As the movie started playing, I suddenly realised This movie was going down very well with this audience.
But then it finished, and I'm looking around, and everyone's on their feet. It's like a 7-minute standing ovation.
And that's when I realised that we had made a movie here that was a very feel-good movie, but at this particular time.
Write your stories, yes. But don't forget us.
There's a line in The Promise where he says, I hit it big once, but I paid a big cost. Inside, I'm carrying the broken spirits of all the other ones who lost. And I think about that quite often when it comes to thinking about, you know, people like my dad who are not around to see the film. All of us who get anywhere near the privilege of being able to tell their story are only doing it because other people opened the door for them, showed the way to them, sacrificed for them. I think the fact that I was able to hopefully share his story with the world, first generation immigrants who just tried to do the best, but they saw the world in different ways to their kids, I think that was my way of honoring him and honoring that generation. And I guess that's the best one could do.
I think Bruce Springsteen could understand my dad. Because like his father, they both came from poor backgrounds, both worked hard in factories, both had dreams that never came true, which left them angry. And they both had sons who wanted a chance to make them proud.
I make films about people who are generally on the margins, people who you would see on the edges of frames, and then I take them and put them in the centre of the frame.
Gurinder's genius is that she takes subjects which some people might consider to be niche and hammers home the humanity and the universality of them.
And the same is true of Blinded by the Light, and that's, I think, Bruce's mission in many ways.
I'm really sorry. Who's that?
Boss.
Who's boss?
The boss of us all.
I wrote something.
Did I ask you to write something?
I had to write it.
It's about music.
A record review.
It's sort of. Can you read it?
The great thing about working with Gurinder is that she is a massive fan as well.
For me, this is a film about the words and music of Bruce Springsteen rather than Bruce Springsteen the man.
But Springsteen. He's more what your dad listens to, not my dad.
It's a memoir, and he had said to me that when he was writing, he was really hoping that I would want to direct something because he felt that I was the only person who would understand the cultural specificity of what was going on.
Just listen to me.
You listen to me. Huh? You think that this man sings for people like us?
But he talks to me.
Sarfraz was trying to protect his parents. He did that thing that people like us do, sons and daughters of immigrants, you know, where we're saying, yeah, this is a problem, but at the same time, we don't want to throw our parents under the bus.
Gurinder just said, you're never going to be liberated. You're never going to be free unless you change these people's names.
And it all goes full circle from him not hating his dad, but just being aware of the fact that his dad was holding him back and not allowing him to do things.
We pushed the conflict a bit more with the parents. We created a girlfriend, and we just took his world and created the movie. It's very important that we remember that this is a film about words and music, and the hero wants to be a writer. But also, it's about the values of Bruce Springsteen, which immediately touches Javed, but then also is really what the film's about. What kind of world do we want to live in?
Lay back, please! Action!
Don't run back inside, darling, you know just what I'm here for. So you're scared and you're thinking that maybe we ain't that young.
We wanted Springsteen's music to be a character in the film, and we also wanted it to illuminate and push the narrative along.
So the responsibility for me in writing the script was to take those words and place them then into my story and how I wanted to then contextualise them for Javed. And it was amazing the connections between a young Bruce growing up in New Jersey and writing about being trapped in a town full of losers, you know, and pulling out of here to win.
Well, no, I'm no hero, as understood.
One of the biggest things she said to me was just own it, own it, own it, and it would just comes if you do.
I went with Vivek because I really thought there was someone here who had some magic, and he just went for it.
And cut!
He'd never even listened to Bruce Springsteen before the movie, but now he's a massive fan.
I carried on listening, and I carried on listening, just like the character does. And his words have a lot more depth to them than a top 40 song.
I got introduced to Vivek, and he's like, I think he was 19. And I was like, oh my God, you know, I'm literally trusting you with my life.
I'm stuck in Luton, one of the herd. No fun, freedom, or future, because Luton is a four-letter word.
Sarfraz grew up in Luton, so obviously the film had to be set in Luton.
It's been nice to see Luton. I'm really glad that we didn't do it all in a studio and we actually went to the place.
In 87, 88, there was mass unemployment and people felt that there was no future and no hope.
So the first day they had taken over a school and I see Vivek, I see Aaron, there's Roops. It was so weird.
To be there and they're all like 80s'd up and to be in a little capsule of 80s-ness is amazing.
My dad drove a sunflower yellow Vauxhall Viva. That's what they found.
Great day to wear a suit, no?
Great day, I'm getting a bit hot as well. Underneath the collar.
They sourced clothes that my dad wore. Gurinder and the crew, they were really sensitive and determined to get things authentic.
We wrap in 16 minutes. And we're trying to do two shots in 16 minutes. 12-hour days. You can only do that if you are really, really passionate about what you're doing.
I think she's really powerful and brilliant at making cinema that actually affects your emotions.
I'm sorry, I don't know if I can read this.
I'm really happy if it looks great and sounds great, all that is great, but unless you're going on that emotional journey with me, then I feel that I haven't really done my job.
The thing that's really powerful about the film, yes, it's Springsteen, but it could be the Beatles, it could be Dylan, it could be Jay-Z, it doesn't really matter who it is. It's about the feeling of being young and excited by new possibilities.
Reset, please!
It's extremely relatable. It just so happens to be set in Luton and the story of a Pakistani kid, but actually, it's your story too. That's what I try and do as a filmmaker, you know, make universal stories. They're just with people who you might not think you relate to, but actually you do.
That is a wrap! What an amazing 6 weeks! Amazing 6 weeks! Absolutely exhausting!
Still coming to my party tonight?
Yeah, of course.
Emma's mates are coming, and I know one who would be perfect for you.
She's not fussy.
Really?
First day, start at the top and stay there. Stay away from the girls!
I want to be a writer, but my family is stuck in another century.
Writing isn't a job. I need you to do more.
Make a wish, Peter.
Kiss a girl and get out of this dump.
Bruce is the direct line to all that's true in this shitty world. Seriously, what does he know about our world?
You should be listening to our music before you start getting confused and hating yourself.
I listen to everything. I can feel it all right here. It's like Bruce knows everything I've ever felt, everything I've ever wanted.
My poems, they're not brilliant, but they're mine.
You think that this man sings for people like us?
But he talks to me.
You cannot be serious, mate.
My dream was to come here and work hard for my family.
If you don't try to fix this, we will lose our son for good.
This guy is incredible. You've never heard lyrics like his.
Is that Billy Joel?
Billy Joel? You try and raise your kids right, Jay.
Bruce sings about not letting the hardness of the world stop you from letting the best of you slip away. My hope is to build a bridge to my ambitions, but not a wall between my family and me.
Come to see your visit?
I'm going to see Bruce Springsteen's hometown.
I can't think of a better reason to visit the United States than to see the home of the boss.
Traps like us. Baby, we were born to run.
Did you write that? I've told you before, your lyrics are rubbish. That didn't even rhyme!